Auditor General Namsi Gathungu is promising to fast-track the clearing of a backlog of audit reports for state-owned firms in the country. The move will bring a sigh of relief to many listed public firms, which had to put their plans on hold as the country lacked a substantive Auditor General to approve their books. Dennis Otieno reports.
With the stroke of a pen, Nancy Janet Kabuwe Kathungu was formally presented as the country's new Auditor General, taking over from Edward Ouko, whose term expired in August last year. Top on our agenda is freeing state agencies which are yet to hold their annual general meetings due to lack of audited financial results.
And my priority, therefore, will be to put mechanisms to clear the audit backlog as soon as possible so that entities may hold their annual general meetings and development partners can also get feedback on spending of the projects they support. And most importantly, the people of Kenya and other stakeholders can get information on how public resources have been managed.
Besides suspending their annual general meetings, some of the state-owned firms had also declared they will not pay dividends to shareholders. Power generating company KenGen had announced it would only pay dividends to shareholders after their financial statements are approved by the Auditor General. Consequently, the absence of an Auditor General meant that the affected firms would have to seek permission from the Capital Markets Authority to delay publishing their results. Other state-owned firms also affected include power distributor Kenya Power, Kenya Pipeline Corporation KPC, and the Central Bank of Kenya.
I will build it on four critical pillars: independence, credibility, relevance, and accountability.
She now has her work cut out as she replaces Edward Ouko, who had his own tribulations during his tenure. Gathungu's predecessor often rattled the executive, especially when exposing corruption in government, a factor that Chief Justice David Maraga is well aware of as he welcomed the new office holder.
You will step on toes, some of them very thick, including if it is obligatory, that of the Chief Justice. So you are going to have to discharge your duty without fear or favor.
There is therefore high expectation of you from all the stakeholders, including the Mwananchi, who believe, as you rightly said, that you will deliver to the Kenyan people.
And so begins an 8-year term for Nancy Gathungu, who will now officially serve as the country's Auditor General. Taxpayers will be keenly watching her performance, hoping to get value for their money. Dennis Otieno, Citizen TV.